Let's jump right into a quick beam example in ClearCalcs to get you up to speed on navigating through the interface. So I'm going to come here from our project details page to add new calculation. I'm going to click on wood beam, and I'm going to click on generic beam for our example. Know that the rest of those are presets and will function the same way. While this page might look like there's a lot of inputs at first, all we need to do is set our beam plan length, modify our supports. So let's say we're simply supported other than the fact that we're cantilevered by 2 feet on the right-hand side. Notice you can have an unlimited number of supports here if you'd like, and the right-hand side is updating real time. But I'm gonna go ahead and delete that one. And then we wanna put in our loads. We open with a default floor load, but you can put an unlimited number of distributed line and point loads. So let's say floor load 2 from 0 to maybe this one only goes mid-span, capital L over 2, tributary width of 5. And let's say we have a dead load of 20 PSF, and we have a crazy floor here that has also a snow load of 30 PSF. Just to show you, you can add as many load types as you need. And notice this updates real time up here, as well as our shear moment deflection on the right. Now we want to select our member. To make this list a bit more digestible, let's use our filters. Let's say we just want to look at a micro lam LVL. Notice that none of these pass right now, but we know we want this 1¾ by 11¼. So let's try to make this work. Let's say we want 2 plies, and maybe we even want to add some flitch plates to it. That made a pretty significant difference. So now maybe we can come back in here to our selector, go down a size, and now we have the 1¾ by 9¼, and we are all under 100%, so we can print either our one-page standard or detailed summary to send to the permit reviewer or keep on file for our records.